Hello everyone, this tutorial will explain the firmware update of the MiRobot robotic arm. Before the robotic arm leaves the factory, it will be burned with a relatively stable firmware version. If you want to experience the latest version where the current firmware is damaged, you need to reburn it. The first method is to use the host computer to update. First of all, we take out the robotic arm and connect the power supply. We need to pay attention to the data cable, which must be plugged into the body of the robotic arm. Then, we turn on the host computer and press the power button. The robotic arm will return some basic information. The first line is the current firmware version. If we don't see this information, we can press the reset button on the base of the arm. The information will be sent again. After confirming the version, we click Settings and find the device update firmware. Click Update Firmware, you can select a different version and click Upload on the pop-up window. Then we wait. When the upload word appears, it means that the firmware was uploaded successfully. We close this window, click OK. At this time, we have completed the firmware update. Let's check by restarting the arm. We can see that the firmware is changed now. What about the second method? We can use Xloader to burn directly. We can download the corresponding files. We find Xloader in the download file. This method is commonly used when the arm firmware is damaged and the host computer cannot identify the situation of the robotic arm. After connecting the robotic arm, we open the Xloader. In the pop-up window, we select the current firmware file. After selecting it, in the second window, we select Mega 2560. Select the corresponding serial port. The baud rate is 115200. We need to pay attention that if we have turned on the host computer, we need to disconnect it. Then click Upload. Okay, now that the upload is complete, we close the window. Let's go back to the host computer and click Connect again and restart the robotic arm. We can check the firmware version and we can see that we have the firmware version back. These are the firmware update methods for the robotic arm. That is all for this tutorial. Thank you so much for watching.